Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Memory is the diary that we carry about with us, so says Miss Prism in The Importance of Being Earnest. It's a pretty accurate metaphor. Memories hold our secrets, our feelings, and our experiences. But what she doesn't point out is that memories, just like diaries, can be lost. Our thoughts and recollections of the past can be gone in an instant. What we tend to picture when we think of memory loss is what's known as retrograde amnesia. Someone with retrograde amnesia can't remember certain aspects of the past and things they already knew. Generally, amnesia affects a person's short-term memory. They'll remember the name of their childhood dog, but might not remember what day it is or what they were doing immediately before they lost their memory. Amnesia can be caused by a stroke, heart attack, or head injury, just as a few examples. Fortunately, amnesia usually resolves itself without treatment. However, millions of people will experience some form of incurable memory loss in their lifetime. In fact, this year, an estimated 5.5 million people in the US live with Alzheimer's disease, a disease that impacts the brain's ability to form memories. Essentially, Alzheimer's starts with a buildup of bits of a protein called beta amyloid, also known as plaque. The plaque gets in between nerve cells, and as more and more of it builds up, it damages and kills brain cells. According to the Alzheimer's Association, 1 in 10 people over the age of 65 has Alzheimer's. And that's a lot of people. But what does memory loss mean for a person? Is their personality gone too? And what can be done for them? Many researchers are asking and answering these questions. Research shows that losing your memory to a disease like Alzheimer's isn't just about forgetting facts you learned in school or the name of the street you grew up on. It can progress into forgetting how to go through your daily routines like eating and getting dressed. Side effects of Alzheimer's also include personality changes, ranging from apathy to paranoia to indecision. However, in an interview about his experience with the disease, one man who has been living with Alzheimer's for several years said, "We're still in there." But researchers' understanding of the disease can only go so far. They can see the effects Alzheimer's has on people, but typically they don't fully comprehend the feeling of forgetting one's life. According to a first-hand account from one individual who was diagnosed with early-onset Alzheimer's, in order to imagine the disease, you should imagine waking up after a dental procedure or a surgery, some event that involves drugs that erase your short-term memory. But also imagine that you've woken up in a building that you don't recognize, surrounded by things that you've never seen before, and you're all alone. Soon, people start coming into the room and talk to you like you've always known them. Maybe they're your best friend, or your kid, or your spouse, but you have no idea who they are. This is terrifying and heartbreaking to imagine, but it's a reality for so many people, and it's incredibly important to think and talk about. Alzheimer's currently has no cure, but we have many scientists and researchers to thank for devoting their time and work to looking for a cure. If you want to learn even more, check out our sponsor, Abe's Garden Alzheimer's and Memory Care Center of Excellence, a valuable resource for loved ones of those diagnosed with Alzheimer's and related dementias. The Abe's Garden brand new YouTube channel is filled with videos to help friends and family members succeed with everyday care and communication. Professional, practical advice is shared on a variety of topics, from hygiene to engagement to explaining dementia to children. Definitely check out this video and tell them that Blocko sent you.
Often people still don't recognize family members, which is really hard for family members because they're remembering a younger version of you. They may look at a photo album and see their spouse on the day they got married and not recognize their spouse 70 years later.
As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.